Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine. I am a subject teacher of social study, and in our last video we have discussed about chapter number 14. Chapter name is Our Rights and Duties, that is part 1, and in this video we are going to discuss about the part 2 of chapter number 14. So students, now come on the topic. And in today's video, I'm going to discuss about our rights and our duties. So there are certain rights and duties that are given to us by the constitution of our country. So being a citizen of India, some of the moral responsibility and duty mentioned in the constitution are: we must respect the national flag and national anthem, obey the law of our country, protect the power, unity and integrity of the country, safeguard public property, pay our taxes with honesty. So there are certain rights and duties that we should get from our constitution. So topic, come on the topic. Your topic is our rights. Our rights. A right is a power or freedom given to us by law. So student, a right is a power and freedom given to us by the law of, by the law which is mentioned in our constitution. The Indian constitution grants us certain rights. So by the constitution of India, we get the certain rights which are very important. Nobody can deny us this right. Nobody can deny us this right. These are called fundamental rights. So the fundamental rights are defined as the basic human right of all citizens. Their rights, these rights defined in part 3 of the constitution, applied respective of race, place of birth, religion, caste, creed or gender. They are enforceable by the court subject to specific restrictions. So there are certain fundamental rights which are discussed here. First one is right to justice. First one is right to justice, means social, economic and political justice. This means that every citizen's rights are protected by law. People who violate them will be punished. So student, the people who violate the any person, then they can be punished by the law which is mentioned in our constitution, and it is our fundamental rights. Right to justice is our fundamental rights. When anyone can harm, then they are punished by the law which is mentioned in our constitution, and because right to justice is a fundamental rights. So now look at the next, that is right to liberty. Right to liberty. Right to liberty. Liberty means liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship. Here liberty means freedom. Means the citizen of India have a freedom to express their thought, belief, faith and free to follow any religions. First, we are free to follow the religions we wish. So student, the citizen of our country are free to follow any religions according to their wish. Second, we are free to live and travel anywhere in the country. So being a citizen of India, the people can travel anywhere in the country, because right to liberty is a fundamental right. So under this right, the citizen of India is free to live and travel anywhere in the country. Next, we have freedom of speech. That is, we can freely express our opinions without any fear. However, we cannot cause harm to other with our speech. So student, we as a citizen of of India have a freedom of speech. We can express our speech, we can express our thought, belief. So we cannot cause harm to other with our speech. And next right is right to equality. Right to equality. Equality of status and of opportunity and to promote among them all. So all Indians are equal in the eyes of law. Nobody can be denied any right on the basis of being a woman or man, poor or rich, educated or illiterate, or on the basis of belonging to any religion or caste. So student, right to equality is also a fundamental right, and under this right, any person of a country cannot be discriminated on the basis of educated or illiterate, poor or rich, woman or man. They are all treated equally according to the law which is mentioned in our constitution. So right to equality is also a fundamental right which is given to us by the Constitution of India. So come on the next page. Right to education. Right to education is also a fundamental right. The right to education was added to the Constitution in 2002 and came into effect in 2010 with the Right to Education Act. It ensured the right to free and compulsory education to all children between the age of 6 and 14 years. So right to education is also a fundamental right, and this right was added to the Constitution in 2002 but came into effect on 2010. It ensured that every person, every child have a free and compulsory education who age of 6 and 14 years. So student, the child whose age are 6 to 14 years, then they have right to get free and compulsory education under the right to education which is given to every child by the Constitution of India. So now look at the duties. So there are certain duties, and fundamental duties are defined as the moral obligation of all citizens to help promote a spirit and patriotism and to uphold the unity of India. This duty is set out in Part 4A of the Constitution, concern individual and the nation. So our duties, our Constitution also mentioned the fundamental duties. Our Constitution also mentioned the fundamental duties of Indian citizens. Right and duty exist together. For instance, as a child, you have the right to education, food and protection. When you grow up, it will be your duty to look after your parents and to serve society with the education you have acquired. So student, duty are important as right and must be carried out by virtue of being a citizen of a country. So our duty are also mentioned in the fundamental duty, mention the fundamental duties, and every person have a fundamental duties are added to the moral obligation of all citizens to help promote a spirit of patriotism and to uphold the unity of India. And when you grow up, it will be your duty to look around, to look after your parents and to serve society. So look at the, there are some fundamental duty which are mentioned here, which are given here. First, to follow the rules laid down in the Constitution. So student, it is our duty and it is our moral obligation that we should follow the rules that are mentioned in our Constitution of India. Second, to respect the national flag and national anthem. So student, being a citizen of India, we should respect the national flag and national anthem. Next, to defend our country from foreign attack. So student, we should protect our country from foreign attack. To treat all Indians with love, respect and equality. So student, we should treat all Indians with we should not discriminate on the basis of caste, creed or religion. We should treat all Indians with love, respect and equality. Next, to protect the environment. So student, we should protect the environment. We should not destroy the environment. We should not pollute the environment. We should protect the environment by planting more and more trees and clean the air. Next, to protect national property like monuments, parks and roads and so on. So student, and next duty of our of a city, next duty of a citizen of India is being a citizen of India, we should protect national property, monuments means old building which is related to our past time, like monuments, and we should also protect parks, roads and so on which is available in our society, and we should not destroy and we should not harm this property. So student, I hope you all are understood about our rights and duty, and you have to read and learn about our rights and duty. This is your today's homework. So that's all, and thank you.